We identified some key questions the WWC considers when reviewing a study design. The first question is, do the authors say they used random assignment or call the study an RCT? If the answer is yes, then check to see whether each unit appears to have had a non-zero probability of assignment to each condition. Then, determine whether the authors used different assignment probabilities for different groups. If so, does the analysis account for that? Paying close attention to how the authors describe the group formation beyond the labels they use, as well as answering these key questions, will help determine whether the study is eligible to meet WWC Group Design Standards without reservations. That is, reviewers should ensure that the description of the group formation reflects the type of design the study authors say they used. For example, study authors may claim to use an RCT design, but in reading the study, a reviewer might discover that the process they used was not truly random. We have a matching game to help you practice what you've learned. In this game, you will match a phrase in the left column with a phrase in the right column. Okay, the first item in the left column is randomized controlled trial. Does it match to choice A, B, or C? Please feel free to pause the video at this point so that you can read through the answer choices first. The answer is B. Researchers flip a coin to determine whether they are in the intervention condition or the comparison condition. This answer is correct because it describes a completely random process. The coin has two sides, there are two groups, and participants can go into either one. The second item in the left column is quasi-experimental design. We're left with choice A or C as options. The answer is C. Uses existing sections of algebra. Students in first, third, and fifth period algebra classes are in the comparison group. Students in second, fourth, and sixth period algebra are in the intervention group. There are two distinct groups, and the study does not use random assignment, which means this is an eligible quasi-experimental design. That means the last option in the left column, not eligible for review, matches to choice A. Examines the fall and spring test scores of the 7th grade physical science class. This is an ineligible design because there is no comparison group. The 7th grade science class represents one group. The study looks at that same group before and after the intervention, which researchers call a pre-post design. Scores might go up for many reasons, and many of those reasons are not related to the intervention. These kinds of pre-post designs with no comparison group are not eligible for review under the WWC Group Design Standards. Time for your first knowledge check. A study assesses the effects of a new curriculum for elementary school students by examining differences between school-level test scores in the fall before the intervention and in the spring after implementation of the intervention. Is the study a randomized control trial, quasi-experimental design study, or neither? The answer is C. The study is ineligible for review under the WWC Group Design Standards. There's only one group in the study. The study examines scores of the group in the fall and the scores of the same group in the spring. Without a comparison group, we worry that normal maturation in the students might affect the results. Students know more as they get older and learn more. Without a comparison group, we can't tell whether the intervention is truly causing students' test scores to improve or students are just learning more as they get older. Choice A is incorrect because there was no random assignment. Choice B is incorrect because eligible QEDs require at least two distinct groups. Knowledge check 2. A study estimates program impacts separately for subsamples with different assignment probabilities and averages the subsample specific impacts to calculate an overall program impact estimate. Would the WWC accept this method of accounting for the different random assignment probabilities? Your choices are A, yes, this is appropriate. B, no, the authors must either use dummy variables for the different subsamples in a regression model or use inverse probability weights. C, no, the WWC would need to ask the authors for subsample specific results, or D, there's not enough information. The answer is A. This is an appropriate approach. The study used different assignment probabilities and needs to account for them in the analysis. According to the WWC, estimating separate impacts and averaging them is one of three acceptable ways to account for different assignment probabilities. Choice B is incorrect because it includes only two of those acceptable approaches. Choice C is incorrect because the WWC does not need the separate subsample impacts. Choice D is incorrect because the description of the approach is sufficient. Knowledge check 3. Study authors randomly assign students to intervention and comparison groups. However, the authors purposefully assign one student to the intervention condition based on the student's needs. In what situation can such a design receive the Meets WWC Group Design Standards Without Reservations rating, if at all? A. The study identifies the unit and assigns it before the random assignment process and includes it in the analytic sample. B. The study identifies the unit and assigns it before random assignment process and excludes it from the analytic sample. C. The study identifies the unit after random assignment ends and the study authors change the group of the unit. Or D. This design compromises the random assignment process, so the study cannot receive the Meets WWC Group Design Standards Without Reservations rating. B is the correct answer. Purposefully assigning a student to one condition outside of random assignment does not compromise the random assignment, as long as the study identifies the student before random assignment and does not include the student in the analytic sample. Choice A is incorrect because including a unit that the study did not randomly assign in the analytic sample compromises the integrity of the random assignment process. Choice C is incorrect because changing the condition of units after random assignment compromises random assignment. Although the existence of non-randomly assigned units can compromise random assignment under some circumstances, choice D is also incorrect because these units do not compromise random assignment when the study identifies them before random assignment and does not include them in the analytic sample. Knowledge check 4. To evaluate a pull-out computer-based reading program, researchers select a class of 20 students. The researchers select 10 students at random to use the program. The other 10 participate in the normal class activities. The WWC would consider this study A, a randomized control trial, B, a quasi-experimental design study, or C, a study that is not eligible for review under the WWC Group Design Standards. The answer is A. This is an RCT. The study randomly assigned all 20 students in the experiment. Assignment was entirely by chance, and each unit had a non-zero probability of assignment to each group. The study text doesn't provide any reason to question the randomization process, so we can conclude this is an RCT. Choices B and C are incorrect. The study is not a QED because it used a random process to create the groups, and this is an RCT, so it is eligible for review. Note that the initial selection of the 20 students to participate in random assignment has no bearing on the eligibility of this study as an RCT. It does not matter how the researchers identify the population of students subject to randomization. Knowledge check 5. Authors evenly grouped 90 schools into urban, suburban, and rural. From each of these groups of 30 schools, the authors randomly selected 4 schools. In each of the groups of 4 schools, the authors randomly assigned schools to one of the following conditions: instruction at home and school, instruction at school, and no instruction control. The WWC would consider this study A, a randomized controlled trial with stratified or blocked assignment, B, a quasi-experimental design study, or C, a study that is not eligible for review under the WWC Group Design Standards. The answer is A. The researchers used a stratified randomization process. They stratified schools based on the area type and then randomly selected 4 schools from each of those strata. Lastly, the study authors randomly assigned those schools to one of 4 conditions. So, the study assigned units entirely by chance, and each unit had a non-zero probability of assignment to each group. Choices B and C are incorrect. The study is not a QED because it used a random process to create the groups. And this is an RCT, so it is eligible for review. Note that the authors randomly chose the four schools in each strata that would be subject to random assignment. If the researchers had instead used a non-random method to choose those schools, or if the schools had volunteered, the study would still be considered an RCT. This is because it does not matter how the researchers identified the population of units subject to randomization. Knowledge Check 6. An author uses early childhood longitudinal study kindergarten cohort data to estimate the impact of preschool attendance. In these data, some children attended preschool and some did not. The author compared outcomes between these two groups. The WWC would consider this study a randomized controlled trial with stratified or blocked assignment, b a quasi-experimental design study, or c a study design that is not eligible for review under the WWC Group Design Standards. The answer is B, it's a QED. The two groups are not the result of random assignment. The study authors compared two distinct naturally occurring groups, children who did and did not attend preschool. Choice A is incorrect because the study did not use random assignment. Choice C is incorrect because the study design has a distinct comparison group. This concludes our review of group designs, Module 1 of the WWC's Group Design Standards training. Let's review what we learned in this module. We discussed the two research designs that are eligible for review using the WWC Group Design Standards, randomized controlled trials, and quasi-experimental designs. We also reviewed how to identify eligible RCTs with well-executed randomization, as well as how to identify eligible QEDs. Up next in the training series, we will discuss the WWC's attrition standard in Module 2. Just a few final reminders. You can access all the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. Please note that the full slide deck for this module is available on the WWC website. This includes detailed responses to the knowledge check questions. To receive a certificate of completion for viewing these training modules, you must view the videos on the WWC website. Thank you for viewing the Group Designs module.